Well, the first thing is the necessity to rebound the ball from the perimeter position. You know, we talked about that, you know, expecting them to come out and shoot a bunch of threes. There was going to be some long rebounds, and we needed one of our perimeter guys or multiple of our guys to come up big on the defensive boards for us. You know, the 10 defensive rebounds showed that he did that. The assists come from, you know, him recognizing the game and seeing the plays that are there in advance and not reacting. You know, he's manipulating defenses because he knows what to expect now. And I think he did that over and over again, you know. And then obviously, you know, the points. Now, that, again, he got good looks, had some didn't go down for him. But, you know, it's just his ability to impact the game on both ends of the floor from that position.
We've talked a lot about Mason before, but even tonight, he's breaking his career high yet. And just his, what have you just seen his, him taking this opportunity and really showcasing who he is on both ends of the floor?
Well, you know, the defensive part is what we expect, and that's why he earned his way onto the floor. You know, offensively, if you go back and watch his college career, you know, he knows how to score the ball. And I think he was almost going to be the all-time leading scorer at Penn State before the season got shut down. So he knows how to score the basketball. But what I think he's doing now is he's finding his opportunities and taking his shots. You know, he doesn't have to be a jacker from three. You know, especially playing that two-guard position, he's got a size advantage. And, you know, his game is in the paint and in the mid-range. Obviously, he's been working on his three-point shot, and when he's open, he's capable. We've seen that over and over again. You know, he shoots a good percentage. But I think, you know, you're seeing the patience and him finding his spots.
And we talked about learning experiences and what did you see tonight and how the guys were able to do so?
We didn't change. And I think that's the most important thing. You know, we didn't start messing with the game. You know, we took all 48 minutes of it seriously. You know, and we talk about playing with purpose, playing with discipline. And I thought they did that tonight in the fourth quarter as well.
Serena.
Serena Winters, Valley Sports. JB, I know you already chatted about the triple-double that Darius had tonight, but talking more about the emotion on his face when he actually went to drive in for that layup, knowing that was a triple-double, and then being able to watch him with you and with the coach on the sidelines, what that meant to him. What can you tell us about being around him and why that moment was so big?
He's the type of person that you root for. You know, he's the type of person who every day you want to be around. You know, he takes his job extremely serious, but, you know, at the same time, his personality is bigger than himself, you know, and all he thinks about and how the way he carries himself is just about the people that are around him. And it's not just basketball. Like, he doesn't just show up to work and become somebody else. Like, this is the type of person that he is on and off the floor. So, you know, when you see someone like that be successful, you know, or accomplish a goal, you know, it is that special. Like, you do pull for people like that, and Darius deserves it.
Lowry had one of the best games that we've seen as of late. What went into that performance? And I know we talked about him last game, but what did you see from him tonight with him being so impactful?
Just the confidence and belief in the shot. You know, our message to Lowry all the time is, you know, whether the shots are going or not, you're a big part of what we do. So just keep taking the shots with confidence and they'll go because you are a good shooter. So I think that's what we've seen is, you know, him focusing on the other things and then letting the offensive end come to him and then gaining that confidence and then being, you know, taking more of those shots.
And then that 21-0 run in that third quarter, was it the defense that you saw as the engine for that? And if so, what specifically?
Yeah, I mean, that the defense, you know, being able to take guys away from their strengths, you know, to hold a team, you know, with offensive firepower, you know, as the Jazz have to 16 points in a quarter, you know, speaks that your guys are getting things done. I think, you know, what these games come down to is personnel and individual skill sets and having an understanding of what your opponent is trying to do. And I thought we did a good job tonight of trying to take guys away from their strengths.
Thanks, JB.
Thank you.
Evan. Evan Damerhall, Facebook News. JB, is Darius's back doing okay?
Yeah.
I mean, I'd hope so. So to you, what does it say to you with the performance he gave tonight to kind of gut it out when dealing with maybe some of the lingering issues and get his first career triple-double?
Yeah, I mean, the growth goes from a physical impact to a mental impact. And for him to come up with 15 assists and not shoot it as well as he typically does, like, that shows that this is clicking and that, you know, the game is slowing down and he's figuring it out. Again, understanding that we needed to rebound the ball on the defensive end, especially long rebounds because of the 3-point shot, and then him going to get 10 of them, you know, again, speaks to, you know, his ability to take that information and implement it on the floor. So, you know, that's where the greats become the greats, is because they can outthink, right? And it doesn't always have to just be a physical thing. And you're seeing Darius be able to manipulate the game with his mind.
And we talked about this after the win over Sacramento, but you said it's still a bit of a work in progress where you want the guys to play a full 48 minutes. Did you see a lot of that tonight against Utah?
Yeah, I thought we got to about 44. But no, I thought they did. I thought they did a really good job of maintaining and, you know, playing consistent throughout the entire game.
Joji Kezakam, Coach Evan's so good on the defensive end. I mean, he's good everywhere. But before the trip, and when you kind of were down point guard, you said your big men passed the ball so well. Evan averaging 6 assists over the last 2 games, 7 tonight. How good is he? I mean, what more can he do to surprise you?
It is impressive. You know, we talked about it pregame, like his poise and patience, his ability to read the floor and just make the right play. And, you know, again, I think that's where we're fortunate, you know, to have his ability as, you know, not just a offensive, you know, scoring threat, but when the ball's in his hands, his teammates know their options. So his teammates are willing to do more because they know if they do the right thing, he's going to deliver the ball to them.
And then just quick on Lowry, I apologize if someone asked, but how different is he's hitting his shots?
Lowry comes into this thing as an offensive weapon, right? Like, that's who he's been for his entire career. But we value him as more than that. His ability to switch defensively and play the game that we play, you know, at his size is why we've been able to improve defensively, because of his willingness to do it. And then, you know, the shot making is obviously a bonus. He's a weapon out there and teams are forced to cover him. But again, they're worried about Darius and Evan and Jared on the roll. And now he carries that gravity. He helps those guys as well. So, on any given night, you know, we believe he's capable of going off, but he's going to continue to do the right thing by the team.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, Coach. Congratulations on the win. First of all, Chris Estelas is in Greece. Coach, speaking about the effort and the whole 48-minute game, it was one of the best or maybe the best two-way game for this season from your perspective.
You said it was – I missed the last part of the question.
One of the best or maybe the best two-way game for your team this season.
Yeah, I think it was. Again, we talk about, being the best version ourselves for as long as we can. And I think tonight we did that. Obviously we weren't perfect, but I thought for the most part, you know, we stayed within ourselves, for 48 tonight.